Hi there, this is Jeff Reeves, editor of InvestorPlace.com. I'm here with Charles Sizemore of Sizemore Capital Management. So Charles, let's talk Netflix here. Stock's up big time, almost a factor of five in the last year or so. Some people say it's kind of reshaping digital media and entertainment as we know it. So you a believer, you buy that hype?
Well, I am a subscriber myself, as I believe you are.
I am.
As are millions of Americans. This is a revolutionary company. They have taken, they are really rewriting the rules for media distribution. Because of Netflix, now on-demand media is really what everybody expects. You want it at any time, all the time. You want the entire library of content at your disposal. They've been instrumental in making that happen. However, that does not mean that once the dust settles, they're going to be the ones profiting from it. I'll give you a perfect example. My 3-year-old loves watching Go Diego Go. That's his favorite show, and so we put it on Netflix for him every morning, until one day it just wasn't there anymore. What happened? Well, Amazon, who is now a well-financed competitor of Netflix, they bought the rights to stream that program, as well as a few others, SpongeBob, Dora. It's unfortunately, I'm all too intimately familiar with these children's shows. But Netflix lost out. You know, they lost out on distribution rights for this content because they got squeezed by Amazon, who's willing to pay more for it. So there's no guarantee that Netflix, who reinvented media, is going to be the one who's left to profit from it.
Yeah, and I mean, that's the ultimate question here, is whether or not the story, the narrative of Netflix is enough to convince investors that it's worth buying into, because the PE is a little on the high side. They're spending a lot of money to build out international operations, which aren't entirely profitable yet. And so investors kind of have to believe in the story of Netflix, but at the same time, I mean, there is competition out there, and it's not just Amazon. There's other people who are going to get into streaming that either are in streaming now or that we don't even know of. That's the thing with disruptors, is that they can be disrupted too. So, you know, overall, do you think that there is staying power simply by being a big brand now? Do you think that that's enough for Netflix to keep them going in the short term at least, or is there a big risk because of all this froth because of the run-up in the last year or so?
I'll answer your question with a question of my own. Did it work for BlackBerry? BlackBerry invented the smartphone. There was no such thing as a smartphone until the BlackBerry came out. Now it is an irrelevant company. You know, why? Because somebody else came out with a better mousetrap, Apple with the iPhone, and then later Google Android, and then later the Windows Phone. So at the end of the day, BlackBerry, formerly Research in Motion, they lost out in the revolution that they started. Am I saying Netflix is going to go the way of BlackBerry tomorrow? No, I'm not. I'm just saying be very careful here before you bet your retirement on it. Do you want to put a little play money at work buying Netflix? Go for it. It's a very volatile stock. You can make good money. It's like we said, it's gone up by almost a factor of five in the last year. I absolutely would not stake your retirement on it.
Well, that's an important point, is it doesn't matter if you're first in line, you got to make sure that you keep up after that. Just because you have a head start doesn't mean you wind up winning the race, right?
Exactly.
So that's good advice. So we'll keep an eye on Netflix, and we'll talk again soon, Charles. Thanks.
Sounds good.